Mandal, and welcome to this new video. In this video, I am going to discuss about why a Python programming is very essential for any type of engineers. Python has many type of applications, such as coding into a various forms of solving various forms of equations, derivatives, integrations, and many more. Different types of problems can be solved, different processing can be done, and many more. So I'm just showing you a basic example. I have took my final year project, which I published a research paper on solar Stirling engine. I'm going to code that whole thermodynamic mechanism into a Python and getting a final result from that. So let's begin with that. So this is the research paper I published. You'll see this is copyrighted. Also, this project has to be patented in further processing. Design and analysis of solar power Stirling engine alpha configuration. I designed a thermodynamic cycle or thermodynamic reverse calculation to extract a bore and stroke diameter of an engine for alpha configuration. And to understand this calculation, you have to refer a research paper which I mentioned in the reference section. So here main thing is, if you want to do this calculation again and again, for me it is very hard tasks. I took 6 months to calculate this reverse calculation and extract the solutions of bore and stroke. So this is the bore and stroke. So what you can do in Python is, you can code this whole formulation into a variable form by providing different equation and different math module into it. After coding, you can change any of the parameters such as pressure, compression volume, temperature ranges, also this power factor. So I already coded this whole thing into a Python programming. So let's move on to that. So let's see here. I imported matplotlib.pyplot as PLT in Python and import math. As I'm solving a mathematical calculation, so I need this math so that the program can be run for pi analysis, and other type of sine and cosine function should be taken into considerations. So let's begin with that. There is a power. I defined a variable function such as power application load factor and different input parameters. These are the comments related to this. After all this, I provided a coded equation so that to calculate a variable value such as work done, thermal efficiency of an engine, heat intake, and actual mass into a cylinder, compression volume such as swept volume, and many other initial pressure, swept volume, and finally diameter and length extraction. So when I'm building this program, I face certain difficulties, so that I have inculted into a different variable form, such as to convert unit to follow a consistent unit system, you have to do various type of unit calculations and provide a specific unit calculation so that you can get a predefined result, as in the research paper I did in manual calculation. So what you can do is, so let's go for this tool and get build this. So after building this program, or compiling, you'll get that I found my result, such as design power is this, work done is this. So as you can see, my diameter, bore and stroke finalization is 51 mm, and according to that I got this 55 mm, because I considered some various input values, such as this in manual calculation I have took 3 digits, but in this calculation I have taken more than 10 digit after point. So that's why these variations happen. So this is the very good practice to good practice to formulate any type of numerical or any type of solution which you are using. So what I can do now, if I'm changing this power application, if I'm changing this as 1 HP, so for 1 HP power application, what should be the diameter of an engine? I can find it quickly. I do not have to do different type of different calculations again and again to obtain that diameter. So let's build this. So this will happen automatically after for power application of 1. The work done is changes. Thermal efficiency of engine is 59%. I'm getting it. Heat added into cycle is suddenly changed. Actual mass in the system is changing. Bore and stroke I'm getting is 119 mm. Approximate it should be taken as 120 mm for alpha configuration Stirling engine. This type of formulation you can do for any type of simulation or any type of research which you are inculcated with. So now if I'm for power application 1, if I'm sorry, power application of 0.5, I have to add a load factor of suppose 5 and get and build. So again I am getting the same result, but here the design power is changed and work done by the engine change, and similarly the other parameters changed. So in every field, in every type, any type of engineer, which may be a civil engineer, information technology engineer, mechanical engineer, any type of engineer, use this Python programming for research and any other purposes for solving different types of numerical solutions. Python doesn't do a formulation only a formulation. It can do many more. It can solve a derivative integrative problems and partial derivatives. So I'm having one program, so I can we can also plot a graph from this. So let's build this defined program. So I'm getting it that for this partial differential equation which I solved, this is a Newton second law of motion, how a pendulum moves. So in this type of, you'll get a different type of graph. So here main motto is to show you that how a Python works and how you can use a Python coding to reduce effort into any research application or solving any type of numerical and changing a parameter again and again and getting a different types of solution. You can also plot a graph with this by adding an array into it, but array addition I'll be explaining into a next video. That's all for guys. Thank you.